Chapter 8 in your textbook discussed Biosphere 2, a fascinating project where 8 scientists attempted to live for 2 years in a human-made environment, completely sealed off from the rest of the Earth system. Just thinking of that makes me claustrophobic. The project had 2 stated goals. First, to prove that a self-contained system could support life. And second, to learn about the Earth's delicate balance in order to better protect the Earth. As you read when you read the chapter, the first goal was not reached. But the many problems they encountered definitely helped us better understand the Earth. Notably, they also learned that we better take care of the Earth, as we have really no ability to recreate it. So what's in a name? Why call it Biosphere 2? Well, biosphere is defined as the area of the Earth system where life is found. Thus, they took the name Biosphere 2 as they were trying to mimic the Earth by creating another livable space, closed off from the Earth. Here in Infographic 8.1, you can see that the term biosphere is also used in the hierarchy of terms that ecologists and other biologists use to describe the different levels of biological organization. Biologists have different names for each level of biological organization. The diagram shown starts with individual organisms. Follow along. A group of the same species of organisms living in the same place at the same time is called a population. All the populations living in the same area at the same time make up the community. And the community plus the non-living environment makes up an ecosystem. Then, large distinct ecosystems determined by climate and identified by the predominant vegetation and organisms that have adapted to live there are called biomes. And, at the top, all the biomes on Earth make up the area on Earth where living things are found, the biosphere. The definitions of the terms are important. You should feel very fluent with these terms, and you should be able to define and use these terms and also give real-world examples. As you hopefully remember, ecology is the field of biology that studies how organisms interact with one another and with their non-living environment. Thus, ecologists are primarily interested in the population, community, and ecosystem levels, and that will be our focus as well. However, just to be complete, if you've taken any biology classes, you know that biological hierarchy also has levels below the individual. Check out this diagram from the textbook Environment by Raven and Berg. As you can see, it starts with atoms. Groups of atoms together make up molecules. Groups of molecules make up cells. Groups of cells make up tissues. Groups of tissues make up organs, which together make up body systems, which together make up an organism. And from then on, it continues as we discussed earlier. Population, community, ecosystem, biome, biosphere. The population is a group of individuals of the same species living in the same place at the same time. A community is all the populations, whether they're plants or animals or bacteria or funguses or whatever, living together in the same area at the same time. An ecosystem also includes the community, but also its non-living components as well. The gases, the rocks, the soil, the air, all sorts of things like that. And then a biome, we said, was a distinctive type of ecosystem determined by climate and identified by the predominant vegetation and organism. Notably, there are 3 general types of biomes: terrestrial, land-based, marine, and freshwater. Within each of these general types, there are many specific biomes. For example, check out Infographic 8.4, which shows many different terrestrial biomes. And it also shows the climatic factors, specifically temperature and precipitation, that produce these distinctive biomes. Take a moment to study that diagram. Now consider Biosphere 2. The scientists that designed the system had to pick and choose which type of biomes to include, which terrestrial biomes of those listed here, which freshwater biomes, which marine biomes. And then within a biome, they had to determine which populations to include. This is no small task. What type of tree, what type of grasses, what type of flowering plants, what birds, what animals, what specific insects and pollinators in order to support the flowering plants, etc. All of the different populations within an ecosystem or biome are so interconnected, it's perhaps impossible to recreate a functioning system with only a handful of different populations. They tried, but they failed. As they were picking the biomes and the species within those biomes, they always had to keep in mind the function of the entire biosphere. So how does the biosphere function? It functions primarily through two fundamental processes, energy flow and nutrient cycling. Let's look at that statement a little closer. Energy flow and nutrient cycling. The Earth is energetically open and materially closed. So what does that mean? It means that energy comes in and out of the Earth system, but matter, like carbon and water and nitrogen and oxygen, does not. Biosphere 2 was designed like the Earth. It allowed in sunlight, but was closed to any sort of matter entering and leaving. As a consequence of being closed, a closed system for matter, anything that scientists or other organisms in the system ate or breathed or otherwise used had to come from within the system. Further, all the waste of the organisms stayed within the system as well. This next slide shows much the same thing. Energy comes in from the sun and leaves as heat, but matter does not enter or leave the Earth system. Solar energy is the primary energy source for the Earth system. The only other energy source is geothermal heat from within the Earth. The flow of energy from the sun enters the Earth system and is passed from organism to organism, starting with plants and other photosynthesizing organisms, along the food chain. At each step along the food chain, some useful energy is lost as heat, until eventually all the useful energy is used up. Indeed, energy flows through an ecosystem. It is not cycled. Thus, the Earth and Biosphere 2 need a constant energy source. On the other hand, matter cycles within ecosystems. In fact, the materially closed Earth system has essentially the same amount of water and carbon and nitrogen and phosphorus, etc., today as it did 1 million years ago, and it will have the same amount 1 million years into the future. The law of conservation of matter states, matter is neither created nor destroyed, but it does change form.